Let us study gravitational lines of forces. About gravitational lines, we can write few points to understand these better. We can, very first point we can write that these are hypothetical lines in gravitational field which gives information about direction and magnitude of gravitational field strength at a point in the region. At any point in the region, gravitational lines of force gives us the whole idea or information about direction and magnitude of gravitational field. How these gives the information, let's also discuss the same. We can write in a region, these lines are drawn, these gravitational lines of forces are drawn such that tangent to any point on a line gives the direction of G vector, that is gravitational field strength vector at that point, and density of lines in the neighborhood of a point are proportional to the magnitude of G vector. This is the basic statement about gravitational lines. We can write that in any region in the neighborhood of a point, the density of lines are proportional to the magnitude of gravitational field, and tangent at any point can be written as direction of magnetic field. Like in a region, if gravitational lines are drawn like this, say if these are gravitational lines of forces, GLFs, then we can say if there is a point A here and there is a point B here, we can say at point A, we draw the tangent of this line. You can simply state this is the direction of gravitational field at point A. And at this point, if we draw the tangent of this line, this is the direction which can be written as gravitational field at point B. And if we talk about the density of lines at point A, these lines are closer or denser, and at point B, these are rarer or far apart. So, we can simply state the magnitude of gravitational field at point A is more than magnitude of gravitational field at point B. This is the basic idea about the gravitational field which we can get from the configuration of gravitational lines of forces. Now, say if we discuss the configuration of gravitational field lines in the surrounding of a point mass, then you can see the situation will look like this picture. Here there is a mass M, and in its surrounding we can simply state that gravitational field will exist in radially inward direction. And in this situation, these straight lines which are directed towards the center of this mass M are representing the gravitational field lines. And in this situation, in its surrounding, you can say there is no other mass present, that's why the gravitational field lines are straight. If we place another body in its surrounding, then the gravitational field, net gravitational field, will be affected due to the presence of other mass. Say we draw another picture which gives you an idea about the gravitational field lines due to two masses placed near to each other. Here you can see in this picture, this picture shows the configuration of gravitational field lines in the surrounding of two masses placed at some separation. And why the configuration looks like this, that also we can see, as we have discussed that direction of a G vector at any point in a space is given by tangent to gravitational line of forces, and magnitude of G vector gives us the idea about the density of line. So, density gives us the idea about magnitude of G vector. Now, in this situation, at any point in a space, say there is a point x. If we just talk about the gravitational field x due to this mass, it must exist in this direction and say this G1 vector. And at point x, due to this mass, gravitational field will be directed towards this. And its magnitude will be more as it is closer and say it is G2 vector. If we talk about the resultant of these two vectors, this resultant will be in this direction, which will be G at point x, and you can see this resultant will be in existence at point x, which is the tangent to the gravitational line of force which is passing at point x. Similarly, at any point in a space, say we consider a point y here, so you can simply say due to this gravitational field due to this mass and gravitational field due to this mass, the resultant of these two will exist in a direction of tangent to this gravitational line of force which is passing through point y. Similarly, we can say at every point the tangent to gravitational line of force gives us idea about the net gravitational field of the system, not due to an individual mass. So, this is the way how we draw the configuration of gravitational field lines in the surrounding of two or more masses.